looking a bit grim just last week, but now Target Field is beautiful as ever and ready for opening day against the visiting Cleveland Indians. And it is all now just 6 days away. We welcome you back inside Mall of America studio for Wild Live, joined by a very special guest, Twins president and CEO Dave St. Peter. Good to see you. How are you?
You know, it's great to be here. We're 6 days away from the opener. Mother Nature's cooperated. Let's play some baseball.
Let's hope she continues to cooperate, right? Well, we're 6 days away from what I think is just one of the most fun days in professional sports. Opening day, there's nothing like it, and there are still some seats available if fans want to get in on the action.
That's right, Audra. We have a limited number of seats available for the opener. They start at just $15 for an access seat, and we certainly expect to sell out. First 30,000 fans will get a puffer vest, and we've got a wonderful day of festivities with Justin Morneau throwing the first pitch, a Harmar superstar singing the anthem, of course, Rocco Baldelli managing his first ever Major League game. It's a can't-miss day for Twins fans.
And you guys do such a great thing as not, you know, opening day, first pitch, yeah, it's 3:10, but you do such a good job of making it a full day long celebrating open day. What can fans expect?
Well, I think it's a great tradition. You know, we start with breakfast on the plaza from 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. We open the gates at 1 o'clock with all of the greats of Twins baseball on hand to open those gates, and obviously all kinds of other festivities planned inside the ballpark leading up to that 3:10 first pitch.
Yep. And you touched on it, some of the things, the puffer vests for fans coming in. Justin Morneau, we all love getting to see him throw the first pitch, but tell us a little bit about the new Gate 34 experience.
Well, we've remodeled that gate, all aimed at putting more throughput, helping fans get into the ballpark easier, helping fans get out easier. We've also added a new pavilion area there that's going to kind of rotate over the course of the year with all kinds of different vendors, many of them community-based. We've added some AstroTurf, and we've also reimagined the batter's eye. We've brought greenery back in there, replacing the trees from 2010 with a new living wall, one of the largest in North America.
It's going to be such a great day, and just the experience in itself is awesome. But let's talk a little bit about the product on the field, because we're getting right to it in a division matchup against the Cleveland Indians. There's been a lot of changes with your ball club. What can we expect?
Well, obviously, the Rocco Ball. I think that's where it starts. We think we've had a great offseason, adding Nelson Cruz and Jonathan Scope and CJ Krohn and others. Offensively, we like our team a lot. We think we have enough pitching to obviously play meaningful games late and hopefully challenge Cleveland and others. But I think the key to this club is going to be that young core of players, whether it be Byron Buxton or Eddie Rosario, Max Kepler, Jose Barrios. Mm-hmm. We think that group is ready to take another step forward, and hopefully that will propel us back into playoff baseball.
Yeah, there is a lot to like on that roster, and we are going to see it all up close and personal. Just 6 days. Again, tickets still available if you want to be there for all of the action of opening day. Dave, great to see you. Thanks so much for being here today.